Hello everyone. We have just finished our coffee break and now we are going to another presentations. Just now, Dr. Mehmet Akurgaz from University of Ljubljana, Slovenia. He's the invited speaker of APMAS Congress. He's going to present his presentation. The title is Underlocking and Welding Effect of the Electrical Machines. Dr. Ilgaz, do you hear me?
Yes, so you can hear me, right? And I can open
Yes,
my
yes.
video.
Yes, it's very clear. Hello
You
again.
can see me.
Yes, we can
Now,
see.
only thing is that I must share my screen, right?
Yes. I would like to remind that this virtual congress is recording. And if you are ready, you can start your presentation.
Okay, just please confirm that you can see my screen.
Yes, we can see it clearly.
Okay, so I can start it.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, this is Mehmet Aypulgaz. I am already obtained my PhD. Now I am researcher at the Electrical Machines Lab in the University of Ljubljana. Today I will present you the our possible collaboration with the Lateral in the Kocaeli University and our lab in the Electrical Machines Lab in the University of Ljubljana. And we will define our approach for interlocking and welding effect on the electrical machines. So in this presentation, firstly, we will focus on the laser cutting and its effects on the material degradation and how we approach the model of this degraded area and how the BH curves are affected because of the deformations caused by the laser cutting. And then I will carry on with interlocking and weldings. So today's electrical machines are produced by different techniques like mechanical cutting, water jacket cutting, laser cutting, and other types. One of the possible way is, as I mentioned, laser cutting, because laser cutting is somehow used to prototype design. But laser cutting is also can cause the deformations in the cutting area, may cause the deformation in the cutting area. So I will show you the how we model and how the material properties of the damage area is affected because of this laser cutting. So our modeling approach can be separated in three parts. One of them is that we will do the transient simulation of this magnetic behaviors of the ferromagnetic material using COMSOL multiphysics. And we will do also magnetic reluctance circuit analysis. And the last one is the power loss calculation. We choose material of M450A, and the inner and outer radius rate should be 90% in order to perform uniform flux distribution properties. Therefore, we choose different type of the toroids like 80, 73, and 6 millimeter. 8 is the outer radius, 73 is the inner radius, and the 6 millimeter is the height of the material, or under 60, 145, and 6 millimeter. So how we model the ring core toroid? So ring core ferromagnetic core has the ring core toroid composed of ferromagnetic core and the primary and secondary coils. As you can see here, that there's an inner radius and outer radius, and for the ferromagnetic core cutting, there are some deformation bits causes on the cutting edges. So you can see here that there is A symbolizing the deformation bit, and the D is the healthy core. This deformation bit depends on the several parameters for the laser cutting. It depends on the laser parameters like cutting speed, laser power, and also the dimension of course, depends on the material. And also depends on the size of the ferromagnetic core. So we will carry on in the next slides how we think about this for modeling of this deterioration caused by the cutting. So for instance, in this slide, we define one ring chord toroid without any undeformed area. So we define the BH obtained by the datasheet. And the second one, we define the same toroid with the deformation area. So D is equal to D1 plus 2 times multiplied by A. So D1 also has the same BH characteristic because it is like a healthy chord. But in the deterioration area, we should assume or we should define a dummy curve in order to presume the how the deformation affects the BH characteristic. So we define another BH characteristic which is lower than, or let's say, which is has better characteristics comparing the healthy one. Then we will model it and simulate it on the console multiphysics somehow in our algorithm to find the deformed area by comparison with the experimental results and with the average BH curve of this material composed of deformed area and healthy material. So for this approach in our algorithm, we can use one example such as mathematical approach. There are different equations, but for instance, we define this exponential approach to assume the BH characteristics of the deformed area. So we use this exponential approach. So for instance, we use MATLAB, and just for beginning, we find the four parameters by using the healthy material. So we give the healthy points, and the blue line is showing to our approach. So as you can see, the results are generally overlapping. So we are also using this approach for assumption of the deformed area in our model by using COMSOL multiphysics and the MATLAB programs. So we can simulate the magnetic flux distribution around 9 millimeter core. So you can see that we change the parameters of the deformed area. So no deformation as the blue curve, and XP means that deformed area is very less in the material. I mean the core is less deteriorated, and the XP when is the 0-1 is really damaged. So you can see that how the curve is changing, and red one has the worst characteristics on the BH. We also change the BH by same approach. So you can see that the blue line is the best option, and the others are going lower because of this changing. And also we use the same approach by fixing the B and changing the H parameters. So you can see that the XH is 1 means that this is healthy, and XH is 133 up to 5 has a worst characteristic. So this one is the correct values, and others are going to shift on the right. And when we combine them together, so you can see that no deformation is the red, and the green ones is the most affected one. So it has worse BH characteristics comparing the healthy one. We also did this repeat the measurements by using experimental setup. So we make three different materials, as in the outer radius 250, inner radius 220 millimeter, and the height is 6 millimeter always. This can be assumed as like a healthy core because the width is very large. So the effect of the deteriorated area is very limited, and it can be considered as negligible. Then we define another one. It is the outer radius is 880 millimeter, inner radius is 73 millimeter, and height is 6 millimeter. So this can be considered as the deterioration has some impact. Therefore, we use we define as like a average component, so the target material, and we define another one. We assume this one is totally damaged because this core is very smaller. Therefore, the outer radius is 40 millimeter. So outer radius, there's a mistake, sorry, it should be. Outer radius is 40 millimeter, inner radius is 37.5 millimeter, and the height is 6 millimeter. So you can see that the healthy shape is this orange one. The red is the average, which means that there's some deterioration effect. And the blue one is just a reference for the totally damaged BH curve. So we can model it, the red one, by the BH characteristics obtained from the orange one and the blue one for the healthy and the damaged area respectively. So then we focus on the interlocking. Interlocking is another process for motor manufacturing, can be used for motor manufacturing. So first of all, we use simulation in the COMSOL multiphysics program without interlocking. So you can, when we make a zoom, you can see the B distribution on the ferromagnetic core. And when we imply the interlockings, this means that there's a soft iron and there's an air, and we use M450 in both simulations. The BH characteristics are changing because of the interlocking. And the distribution is not uniform anymore also. And when we will make the BH comparison, this is BH characteristics, BH distribution without interlocking. And on the right, there's a with interlocking. So in explain my words, in order to obtain, for instance, like a one flux, the magnetic field should be 400 without interlocking. But for the same flux, in order to obtain the same ferromagnetic core, needs around 700 or 650. So this means that when the deterioration is coming, the ferromagnetic core requires more magnetic field to obtain the same flux. So we need more excitation current and also the voltage. This is the main problem caused by the deteriorations introduced by laser cutting or mechanical cutting. Welding is another process that may affect the ferromagnetic properties that can be used in the machine design. It can also increase the iron losses as well as the eddy current losses. And the ferromagnetic properties such as BH characteristics is deteriorated from the welding. This is one picture is the showing the base metal and the welding metal. There are differences. This work is our collaborators in Latorum work. And I found one example on the literature. You can see from the down that how the BH characteristics change from Epstein frame means that there's almost no influence on the cutting, tapered core and the welded core. So you can see that welded core has the worst BH characteristics. And in our collaborators in Latorum, they have made some work on the welding. So they always use the same parameters, but they use different input powers. And when you can see that the power is increasing, the deterioration is going more and more. This is our common paper with Mohammed, still under writing, and I hope we will submit it soon. So to conclude my talk, we introduce laser cutting. And this is one of the process for prototype design for the electrical machine designs. And for basic approach, we did our modeling on the ring core toroids, and they cause a material degradation. And we already start to model the degradation in the deteriorate areas and the healthy core by using COMSOL multiphysics programs. And we already start to do simulations on the interlocking and welding effects. they are another contributors for material degradation. And our future work, we would like to carry on to experimental work on the interlockings especially, and also would like to increase the other options on the welding and with other materials also. One of them is N020, which is commonly used in the automotive industry now. At the same time, we would like to make another aspect of this machine design by you defining thermal analyzings, thermal analysis, heat analysis on the electrical machine. I already started it, but our next mission is to make experimental study. And the final thing is that we would like to make coupled model, which is composed of to combine the ferromagnetic approach and the heat analysis approach in the same simulation program. And we would like to make one model that make a comparison with the experimental study and the simulation. So that's all my talk, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor. This nice presentation and is very interesting work, I think that. Yes, I want to ask all the participants that do you have any questions? If do you have any questions to Dr. Ilgaz, you can write the chat part to your questions, or if you want to ask by yourself your questions, please write the chat part about do you have a question. We can wait a few minutes.
And also they can send me an email for collaboration, yes, or like more detailed questions.
It's end of the conference. And also, as you can see that there's an email of Dr. Ilgaz. You can send him an email and ask your questions. Yes, Professor, there is a question.
Okay. In the chat.
Yes, from the chat. Could you please give us the range variation of A1 compared to D1?
Okay, just let me go there. Understand it. So thank you very much for this nice question, actually. There are several parameters for this range. For instance, in our approximations, we give a percentage of like 10%, but it depends on the main various parameters. For instance, it depends on the height of the material and also the material itself and also the cutting technique, because each cutting technique, like mechanical cutting, like using guillotine or other stuff, punching or laser cutting, it's based on the laser parameters or water jacket cooling. They have different, they cause different deformations on the cutting area. Therefore, it's based on these cutting techniques. But generally, in my experiences or also in the literature review, I can say that the deteriorate area is around changed from 1% to 10%. I don't see any paper or any work mentioning that the deteriorate area is more than 10%.
Okay, could you please explain what's happening if we took more than 10%?
What is the
consequence on the, yes?
You can make it, but you in the reality, I don't think that is a very good approach, because the deteriorate area is also changing, because it starts from the edges. There are more worse BH characteristics, and it is going to be improved side by side or a few millimeters, it is improving. You can make it by this ratio, but in reality, I don't think that you can face an experiment. I mean, when you do microscopic imaging or something like that, you see more than 10 or 15%, let's say.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And also, Doctor, I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Your 10th slide, you said that the blue one is the optimal one.
Let me see. Actually, maybe I made a mistake. XPX1.
Maybe I can hurt the mistake. Sorry.
It's not. This one is the optimal. This one, sorry. The green one.
Green one. Okay.
Must be. Sorry.
Okay. Because of that, maybe I can hurt the mistakenly. I want to ask the standard range is about or not.
Sorry, it must be the green one. And by ratio, the worst one is that when XP is the 0-1, and the best is the it is 1.
Okay, thank you, doctor.
Sorry, I just made a mistake.
We have time. If you want, if any participants want to ask another questions, we can have time.
I go quick to have more questions, actually. We are currently working on several papers now, according to our model. So in a few months, you can type my name and probably, maybe not in a few months, but in a 6 months, probably we will have a publication about interlocking and also welding.
Yes. Okay. I think there is no question for now. As you said, doctor, if any participant want to ask any question to Dr. Mehmet Aypılgaz, you can send him an email and he is going to answer your questions. Yes.
Exactly.
Thank you, doctor, again for your nice presentation.
You're welcome.
And just now we are going to see the one of the pre-recording presentation from the APMAS Congress from Dr. Faruk Enes Oğuz, Kocaeli Üniversitesi, Turkey. But we have about 5 minutes later, we are going to start our pre-recording.